Hi, and welcome to this general overview of estimating an LMN. Here, we're just going to take a really high-level overview of the LMN estimating screens and give you just a taste of what each screen does. There'll be other videos which will walk you through the specifics of how to use each screen. Before we get into the estimate itself, it's important you understand the default budgets tab. Default budgets are where each one of your estimators are going to set up the default budget that they're going to use for either installation work, standard estimates, or service work like mowing or snow plowing. Service estimates mean we're going to go back and do the same work a certain number of times, like mowing. We'll go back and mow the same property 30 times. If I was going to do an estimate like that, I'd use service estimates. And this is the budget I'm going to use to build service estimates by default. Now, you can change a budget on any estimate at any time, but each time I create a new estimate, it's going to look here for which budget I should use as the original or default budget. Same thing with standard estimates here, but standard estimates are for installation or enhancement work. Standard estimates might be days and days long, but what it really means is we're going to go in, we're going to do a project, and then the project's finished. We're not going to go back and do the same thing each time. Standard estimates can also be thought of as installation estimates, and service as service estimates. Make sure each year that you're using the correct default budget for both standard and service. It may be that the owner makes new ones once in a while. They may do it annually. That's probably likely. They may do it even more than annually. So it's important you stay in touch with your owner to make sure you're using the right budget for estimating. But before you build your first budget, come here, make sure the default is set correctly. If you do run different budgets for different departments, you can set that up as well. And when you're happy with your default budgets, click Save Changes. To make your estimates, you're either going to go to standard estimates, that's for installation type jobs, or service estimates, that's for maintenance or service type jobs, jobs where we go in a recurring fashion. I'm going to start with standard and just give you a quick overview. Here's the standard estimates list. On this list, I can do some things like search for a customer, or clear the search and press enter, and all my customers will be listed here. I can filter by all estimates or my estimates. I can sort by date, so I only want to see my estimates for the last 6 months, for instance. And I can also choose whether I want to view active or archived estimates. There's an Excel button here, which will download all my estimate information into an Excel spreadsheet. That's a really handy report because you can do some nice things there, like download all your estimates and then filter by estimate status, for example. Then you could see things like how much sales do you have in each status and how much overhead have you recovered in each status. The new button is what I'm going to use to make a new estimate. When you open an estimate, the estimate has a few different tabs. The first tab is for the customer information. That's where it's going to have things like project name, actor customer information over here on this side, and then some assignment information, who the salesperson is, who the estimator is, what your confidence level that you're going to win this bid is, and who last updated it. There's some new buttons down here on the bottom, which weren't in the previous version of LMN. Here I can go back to the estimate list, and here I can go back to the lead. So this button will take me back to my list of estimates. But maybe I'd like to go back out of this estimate right back to this lead because I actually got to this estimate from the lead. If you want to go back to the lead, hit the back to lead button. You can also hit this button here to open a lead at any time as well. Watch me here. There's the lead that was working on this estimate. Down at the bottom, we have some other buttons that are in a different place than the old LMN, but work the same way. We can flag this estimate as ready for export to QuickBooks. We can save this estimate as a new estimate, which is like copying an estimate. We can archive it, so that's basically how to hide it from day-to-day viewing. We can delete this estimate, or we can save our changes that we've made. Now, for those new to LMN, or even those who used to use the old LMN, the layout of the estimating screen has kind of changed. You used to scroll down a lot. Now, all the information is contained in tabs. So in order to do pricing for this estimate, I need to click the work areas and pricing. I'll cover that in another video, but this is where we'll actually build our prices for this job. If I want to make client notes for the proposal that we're going to hand to the client, the printed proposal or emailed proposal, then this is where I'm going to set that up. Each work area that we create or each subtotal we create can have its own client notes to describe the price for the client. And as I add work areas, they'll appear here in the client notes section, allowing me to type notes to the client based on whatever I want to say. Now, crew notes are exactly the same thing, except for crew notes are what comes out in the cruise version. We'll cover both these client and crew notes in a later video as well, but this is where I'm going to enter specific instructions according to this job for my crew so that I can print them a report that comes out of this estimate that tells them what needs to happen on the job. Analysis is where we're going to look at some key benchmarks and metrics. We're going to be able to compare this budget's targets to what we're doing in the estimate so we can make sure this estimate is helping us hit our budget targets, as well as some other basic information about the estimate. And then when we want to print a report like a customer proposal or like a crew job planner, we're going to do that from the print menu. And that's about it for the general overview of the new estimating. In each one of the subsequent videos, we're going to take each section apart. And we'll go slowly through the customer information, how to build your pricing, how to put notes on proposals, etc. Each one in short videos so we don't have one giant long video that you got to sit through to get to something specific. When you're ready to move on to estimating, I recommend you start watching the subsequent videos and spend some time. The time you spend up front watching the videos and learning the system will pay it back a thousandfold when you realize the little tips, tricks, and shortcuts you can use and learn through the videos that'll help you every single estimate you build down the road. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.